are good to go whenever.
Peach.
All right, so here we go. Yeah, so as I was saying earlier, that so Corbin has recently picked up Ice Climbers, and he's been using them to good effect. But I was a little disappointed that he didn't pull them out for this match. But he says Peach and Zelda are just no good again for his Ice Climbers, so he's just gonna go with what he knows best and rip out the Luigi. That's fine. Okay, anyways, okay, jumping into it.
Two, one, go!
Alright, he's just trying to, yeah, Corbin's just trying to zone here. I sent some fireballs, kind of, okay. Oh, press and pull. Oh, wow, and B-Bro got some really good damage off the down smash there. Right, here we go. Now people are just gonna try and start tossing some turnips at him. Just having started. Alright, down smash. Gain some distance attempt now. Oh. Flip some, yeah, they both trade with the moves there. Oh, and I think that Nair might do it. Oh no, not quite. Yeah. Oh, I tried the sweet spot, but catches him with the down smash. Okay. Great, alright, Nair's. Oh, all right, there you go. We can stash in with a up smash. Yeah, Peach is pretty light, so finishing her off the top is what happens for her more often than not. And like, edge guarding her with her having the float, though, is also pretty tricky, but I've seen it done. All right, so Corbin's trying to get something started here. All right, down smash. Zipping past him again. Alright, so you saw that green flash there. That indicates that Corbin has a misfire on deck, so he can use that whenever. However, if he wants to, I guess, maintain his, like, insane knockback, or can also just finish the stock like that. But yeah, the more you score the misfire, the weaker it gets. So alright, here we go. I'll try to pull another up air blue pen out. Instead of punching the grab. Alright. Oh, there we go. And yeah, that was good stuff by B-Bro, but essentially nullifying his misfire with the sorry. Here another stuff. Okay. Corbin just trying to maintain the space. Doesn't want, yeah, only wants to go on if he can find an opening. There we go. Alright, all right, back air out of shield. Oh, let's see what we're trying to do. He's now turned around. Okay. That might have been punishable, but again, he's... So I think that's the third stock Corbin has taken with the wave dash up smash. Hopefully picks up on that. Then figures out a way to punch it. Does that Nair do it? Yeah, that does. Okay. Knockback growth on that Nair is... wave dash turnaround for smash. Alright. Respect it. Okay, and so... covers? Okay. Towards Corbin having this locked up. He's not really committing himself to any risky situation here. He's playing it real safe. And then I've also dictated the flow of his match, so yeah. Things are heavily in his favor. Maybe we're gonna have to figure something out here. You can't just go into those dash attacks if you're wanting to, I guess, come back, because that's basically missing your trade more often than not, but that part will do it. Okay, so Nary is up again. Alright, oh, wait, 1 sec.
Spencer, what was your result with KST?
Let's go. 3, 2,
back to the match here. So now they've opted to go. Athivo's opted to go to Fountain of Dreams. Alright, okay, Fez's key spot there. Alright. Grab. Let's see what Corbin can get off this. Alright, then again, yeah, Wave dashes in with the up smash. Yeah, I think that's gonna be, I guess, a common theme of this match, like, and especially on this stage too. Oh, tries to snag the ledge from him, but Deep Rose is going to make it back. Does again. Oh, good DI by Deep Rose there. Isn't quite dead yet. Yeah, no, that's just, yeah, I guess, something Peach has trouble in this match. Like, I mean, when Luigi tries to recover, Peach really can't go all that low because, like, that's a risky spot, and her vertical mobility as well is a little limited compared to other characters. However, but if she needs to, I guess, try and push somebody to the blast zone, like, her float really enables her to pulling that off. Tries to get up attack, but gets punched with the forward tilts. Yeah, once again, yes, Corbin just really respecting the space. Oh, and that downer will be right now. There we go. Oh, okay, not quite. Oh. Fourth row. And that's the thing, like, I'm watching this and like I'm trying to figure out a way that Peach can really punish Luigi, like, weaving in and out, and I'm like kind of failing to find one. Like, I think you're wow. That could have been good edge guard by people there, but yeah, Corbin still manages to find a way back. And back to my point of like, I guess, punishing Luigi weaving in and out. I think, yeah, the best answer is probably the turnabout, possibly. Oh, there we go. Nice. That was good by B-Bro. Oh, but Corbin comes down with a downer and sends B-Bro to the boss. Boss on. Yeah, I guess Bebo's game plan would probably have to be along the lines of, like, trying to force Corbin in the corner with his turnips and floating around, and then once he does have him, cornered, try to go for a grab, perhaps. I'm a little still trying to, I guess, figure out the dynamics of this match. But as we see, like, Corbin's just not really, he's not really doing anything unsafe. Just respect his pace, and once again takes it with the Wave dash up smash. Okay, and there he takes it 2-0. Luigi.